Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Good day. Hope you are enjoying good health. I am Hafiz Wahidullah, lecturer in the Department of Pharmacognosy, Faculty of Pharmacy, Hajveri University, Lahore. Today we will study Introduction to Drugs of Animal Origin and Honey, and this is our lecture number 1 for this semester. Before moving to the lecture, we will see outline of today's lecture. In today's lecture, we will study Introduction to Drugs of Animal Origin, Biological Sources of Honey, Production of Honey, and at the end we will study Chemical Composition, Identification Test, and Uses of Honey. Learning outcomes for this lecture. By end of this lecture, you will be able to describe drugs from animal origin, and you will also be able to describe biological source, production, chemical composition, identification test, adulterants, and medicinal uses of honey. Drugs of animal origin. In the previous semester, we studied drug from plant origin. We studied 12 different families from medicinal point of view. In this lecture, we will study drugs of animal origin. Throughout history, the interdependency between man and animal has been profound for food. In the beginning, man has been used animals for food purpose. He has often utilized animal as a sacrifice in his religious ceremonies, as we Muslims do in Eid al-Adha. In addition to our dependence on animals for nutritional needs, our dependence on animals for maintenance of our health is greater today than ever before. In the past, man only used animals for food or for sacrifice in his religious ceremonies, but nowadays man is depending on animals for maintenance of man's health. Drugs of animal origin. A number of medicines, including tablets, injections, capsules, cream, mixtures, and vaccines, contain animal products or animal derived products. For example, gelatin is a partially hydrolyzed collagen. When collagen fibers are partially hydrolyzed, it is converted into gelatin. We will study gelatin in detail in later, which is usually bovine. It means that it is obtained from family Bovidae, members of family Bovidae. If a drug is derived or obtained from member of family Bovidae, then this is known as bovine. And if a drug is derived or obtained from pork, pig, then this region is known as porcine. Gelatin is used in making capsule shells and is one of many types of stabilizer added to pharmaceutical products such as vaccine. In vaccine, as a stabilizing agent, gelatin is also used. One more drug is heparin, which is used is in the form of injectable, and it is an anticoagulant. It is prepared from a porcine source. Here is a list of drugs which are included in our syllabus by HEC, and they are honey, gelatin, shellac, musk, civet, ambergris, cod liver oil, cantharides, and spermaceti. Today we will study honey from this list. Honey. Synonyms for honey. Honey is also known as purified honey or mel. Madhu, in Hindi it is called madhu, and in Urdu it is called shahad. Biological source. Honey or mel is a saccharide. It means that it is a sugary secretion deposited by honeybee. Honeybee name, the biological name of honeybee is Apis mellifera, and other species of Apis such as Apis indica. So honey or mel is a saccharide or sugary secretion deposited by honeybee, which is Apis mellifera, and other species of Apis such as Apis indica in the honeycomb. Order. Order of Apis mellifera is Hymenoptera. Family of honeybee is Apidae. Geographical distribution. These are the regions in which honey is available in abundance, and they are England, West Indies, some parts of Africa, Pakistan, New Zealand, India, and Australia. These are the countries in which honey is available in abundance. collection and preparation, how honey is produced by honeybee and how we can collect honey from honeycomb. First of all, see that honeybees live in swarms and gathered into hive. A hive contains three types of bees. In a hive, there is a single queen bee and the males are drones, and third one, the worker bees, which are undeveloped females. Remember that worker bees are undeveloped females. So there are three types of bees in a hive. A single queen bee, the males are drones, the worker bees, which are undeveloped females. Here is the difference between, morphological difference between the worker bee, queen and drone. Workers are undeveloped females, which are like this. Queen is of this shape and drone are of this morphological shape. Collection and preparation. The nectar of flower is a watery solution containing 25% sucrose and 75% water. Nectars are small pockets which are present beneath the corolla of the flower. At midlife, worker bees begins to out of the hives to collect nectar. At midlife, worker bees go out of the hive and collect nectar. The worker bees possesses a long hollow tube to insert into the nectaries of the flower. They take nectar and pass it into esophagus into the honey sac or crop. There are special structure inside the honeybee which are known as honey sac or crop. The nectar is passed through esophagus into the honey sac. The enzyme invertase present in the saliva convert nectar into invert sugar. The enzyme which invertase enzyme is present in the saliva, and this invertase enzyme convert sucrose into invert sugar, which is a mixture of glucose, fructose and sucrose. On returning the hives, the bees deposit the content into the previously prepared cells of the honeycomb. After filling of honey, the filled cells are sealed by wax, which is also known as propolis, and propolis is also used for medicinal use in apitherapy. And with the passage of time, water gets evaporated, thereby producing honey. When honey is collected, or when there is a invert sugar, there is a maximum amount of water, but with the passage of time, water is evaporated and it produces consistent or concentrated solution, which is known as honey, and it contains approximately 80% invert sugar and 20% of water. Remember that in the beginning it is 25% sucrose and 75% water. Sucrose is converted into invert sugar and water is also evaporated, thus by producing honey, which approximately 80% is invert sugar and 20% of water. To collect honey, the honeycomb is smoked to remove bees. The honeycomb is cut and honey is collected either by drainage or expression. The honey obtained by expression is contaminated with wax. So before using it, we have to purify the honey. For getting purified honey, it is heated at 80 degrees centigrade. When the impurities float on surface, they are removed. These are the honeybees and which are filling cells in the honeycomb. Amazing facts about honey. Honeybees cover a radius of 4 km and visit 4.41 million flowers to make 1 kg of honey. For 1 kg of honey, honeybees have to cover a radius of 4 km and they have to visit 4.41 million flowers to make 1 kg of honey. Another fact about honey is that a single honeybee makes 0.8 gram of honey over lifetime. Over his complete lifetime, it only makes 0.8 gram of honey, which means 1/10 of a teaspoon. Apitherapy. Apitherapy is a type of alternative therapy that uses products that come directly from honeybee, and these products include honey, beeswax, propolis and the pollen grains which are deposited on the honeycomb. Apitherapy is used to treat illness and their symptoms, as well as pain from acute and chronic injuries. Illness that apitherapy may treat include multiple sclerosis and arthritis. Description of honey. Honey is how honey looks like, or how what is the taste of honey? We will see in the description of honey. Appearance, it is pale yellow to reddish brown. Taste is sweet. Odor is pleasant. Specific gravity of honey is 1.35 to 1.36. And taste and color of honey solely depends on the flower from which nectar is collected. So taste may vary region to region. This is the physical appearance of honey, which is yellow, and this is light brown. Chemical composition. Chemically, honey is composed of glucose, which is 30 to 40%, fructose 40 to 50%, sucrose 0.1 to 10%, dextrin, formic acid, basic enzymes, proteins, vitamins, maltose, culling matter, moisture, and pollen grain. So by looking at the composition of honey, we can say that it is a suitable food for infants and elderly patients. Identification test for pure honey. In market there are honey which is not a natural honey, but artificial honey is also sold. So we can test that either this honey is pure honey or artificial or adulterated honey. For this purpose, Fihi's test is used. To perform Fihi test, honey 10 ml is shaken with 15 ml solvent ether for 4 to 5 minutes. Upper ether layer is separated and evaporated in a china dish. On addition of 1% resorcinol in 1 ml hydrochloric acid and added, a transparent red color is formed in a natural honey. If transparent red color is not formed, it means that this honey is not natural and it is either adulterated or it is completely artificial honey. Adulterants. Honey is adulterated with either artificial invert sugar or with sugar cane syrup. Uses of honey. It is used as a sweetening agent because it is a sweet, it has sweet taste, so it can be used as a sweetening agent. Being demulcent. Demulcents are those products or those chemical compounds which have soothing effect on mucous membrane. Being a demulcent, it helps to relieve dryness, therefore recommended for coughs, cold, sore throat, and constipation. It is used as a good source of nutrients for infants and elderly patients. It is bactericidal and prevents infection and promotes healing. Honey mixed with honey and juice is good remedy for arteriosclerosis in brain. It is also applied as remedy for open wounds after surgery due to its bactericidal effect. Summary, what we have studied in today's lecture. We have studied that a number of medicine, including tablets, injection, capsule, cream, mixture, and vaccines, contain animal products or animal-derived products. For example, gelatin is a partially hydrolyzed collagen, which is usually bovine or porcine in origin. We have also studied the biological source of honey, ormel. Honey, ormel, is a saccharide, sugary secretion deposited by honeybee, Apis mellifera, and other species of Apis, such as Apis indica, in the honeycomb. We further studied that honeybees live in swarms and gather into hives, and a hive contains three types of bees: a single queen bee, the males are drones, and the worker bees, which are undeveloped females. We also studied the Fihi test, which is used for the identification of pure honey, and we also studied the medicinal use of honey. Being demulcent, it helps to relieve dryness, therefore recommended for coughs, cold, sore throat, and constipation. Textbooks. Following books were considered during preparation of this lecture. I will recommend that you must go through these books. And honey. The topic of honey is you will find honey topic of honey under the topic of carbohydrates in Muhammad Ali and Textbook of Pharmacognosy by Vero A. Tyler. Thank you for listening. Write any question pertaining to this lecture on Google Classroom discussion board. I will personally reply to your each question. I will also upload a quiz related to pertaining to this lecture. You will have to solve that quiz, and tomorrow in the next lecture I will ask question from that quiz. Jazakallahu khair, ahsan al jazakallahu.